Exodus chapter 26. Moreover, you shall make the tabernacle with 10 curtains of fine twisted linen and blue and purple and scarlet material. You shall make them with cherubim, the work of a skillful workman. The length of each curtain shall be 28 cubits, and the width of each curtain 4 cubits. All the curtains shall have the same measurements. 5 curtains shall be joined to one another, and the other 5 curtains shall be joined to one another. And you shall make loops of blue on the edge of the outermost curtain in the first set, and likewise you shall make them on the edge of the curtain that is outermost in the second set. You shall make 50 loops in the one curtain, and you shall make 50 loops on the edge of the curtain that is in the second set. The loops shall be opposite each other, and you shall make 50 clasps of gold and join the curtains to one another with the clasps, that the tabernacle may be a unit. Then you shall make curtains of goat's hair for a tent over the tabernacle. You shall make 11 curtains in all. The length of each curtain shall be 30 cubits, and the width of each curtain 4 cubits. The 11 curtains shall have the same measurements. And you shall join 5 curtains by themselves, and the other 6 curtains by themselves. And you shall double over the 6th curtain at the front of the tent. And you shall make 50 loops on the edge of the curtain that is outermost in the first set, and 50 loops on the edge of the curtain that is outermost in the second set. And you shall make 50 clasps of bronze, and you shall put the clasps into the loops and join the tent together, that it may be a unit. And the overlapping part that is left over in the curtains of the tent, the half curtain that is left over, shall lap over the back of the tabernacle. And the cubit on one side and the cubit on the other of what is left over in the length of the curtains of the tent shall lap over the sides of the tabernacle on one side and on the other to cover it. And you shall make a covering for the tent of ram skins dyed red and a covering of porpoise skins above. Then you shall make the boards for the tabernacle of acacia wood, standing upright. 10 cubits shall be the length of each board and 1.5 cubits the width of each board. There shall be 2 tenons for each board, fitted to one another. Thus you shall do for all the boards of the tabernacle. And you shall make the boards for the tabernacle, 20 boards for the south side. And you shall make 40 sockets of silver under the 20 boards, 2 sockets under one board for its 2 tenons, and 2 sockets under another board for its 2 tenons. And for the second side of the tabernacle, on the north side of the tabernacle, on the north side, 20 boards. And there are 40 sockets of silver, 2 sockets under one board and 2 sockets under another board. And for the rear of the tabernacle to the west, you shall make 6 boards. And you shall make 2 boards for the corners of the tabernacle at the rear. And they shall be double beneath, and together they shall be complete to its top, to the first ring. Thus it shall be with both of them. They shall form the 2 corners. And there shall be 8 boards with their sockets of silver, 16 sockets, 2 sockets under one board, and 2 sockets under another board. Then you shall make bars of acacia wood, 5 for the boards of one side of the tabernacle, and 5 bars for the boards of the other side of the tabernacle, and 5 bars for the boards of the side of the tabernacle for the rear side to the west. And the middle bar in the center of the board shall pass through from end to end. And you shall overlay the boards with gold, and make their rings of gold as holders for the bars. And you shall overlay the bars with gold. Then you shall erect the tabernacle according to its plan, which you have been shown on the mountain. And you shall make a veil of blue and purple and scarlet material, and fine twisted linen. It shall be made with cherubim, the work of a skillful workman. And you shall hang it on 4 pillars of acacia overlaid with gold, their hooks also being of gold, on 4 sockets of silver. And you shall hang up the veil under the clasps, and shall bring in the ark of the testimony there within the veil. And the veil shall serve for you as a partition between the holy place and the holy of holies. And you shall put the mercy seat on the ark of the testimony in the holy of holies. And you shall set the table outside the veil, and the lampstand opposite the table on the side of the tabernacle toward the south. And you shall put the table on the north side. And you shall make a screen for the doorway of the tent of blue and purple and scarlet material and fine twisted linen, the work of a weaver. And you shall make 5 pillars of acacia for the screen and overlay them with gold, their hooks also being of gold. And you shall cast 5 sockets of bronze for them. Exodus chapter 27. And you shall make the altar of acacia wood 5 cubits long and 5 cubits wide. The altar shall be square, and its height shall be 3 cubits. And you shall make its horns and its four corners. Its horns shall be of one piece with it, and you shall overlay it with bronze. And you shall make its pails for removing its ashes, and its shovels, and its basins, and its forks, and its firepans. You shall make all its utensils of bronze. And you shall make for it a grating of network of bronze. And on the net you shall make four bronze rings at its four corners. And you shall put it beneath, under the ledge of the altar, that the net may reach halfway up the altar. And you shall make poles for the altar, poles of acacia wood, and overlay them with bronze. And its poles shall be inserted into the rings, so that the poles shall be on the two sides of the altar when it is carried. You shall make it hollow with planks, as it was shown to you in the mountain. So they shall make it. And you shall make the court of the tabernacle. On the south side there shall be hangings for the court of fine twisted linen, 100 cubits long for one side, and its pillars shall be 20, with their 20 sockets of bronze. The hooks of the pillars and their bands shall be of silver. And likewise for the north side in length there shall be hangings 100 cubits long, and its 20 pillars with their 20 sockets of bronze. The hooks of the pillars and their bands shall be silver. And for the width of the court on the west side shall be hangings of 50 cubits with their 10 pillars and their 10 sockets. And the width of the courts on the east side shall be 50 cubits. The hangings for the one side of the gate shall be 15 cubits with their 3 pillars and their 3 sockets. And for the other side shall be hangings of 15 cubits with their 3 pillars and their 3 sockets. And for the gate of the court there shall be a screen of 20 cubits of blue and purple and scarlet material and fine twisted linen, the work of a weaver, with their 4 pillars and their 4 sockets. All the pillars around the court shall be furnished with silver bands, with their hooks of silver and their sockets of bronze. The length of the court shall be 100 cubits and the width 50 throughout, and the height 5 cubits of fine twisted linen and their sockets of bronze. All the utensils of the tabernacle used in its service and all its pegs and all the pegs of the court shall be of bronze. And you shall charge the sons of Israel that they bring you a clear oil of beaten olives for the light, to make a lamp burn continually. In the tent of meeting outside the veil, which is before the testimony, Aaron and his sons shall keep it in order from evening to morning before the Lord. It shall be a perpetual statute throughout their generations for the sons of Israel. Exodus chapter 28. Then bring near to yourself Aaron, your brother, and his sons with him from among the sons of Israel to minister as priests to me. Aaron, Nadab, and Abihu, Eleazar, and Ithamar, Aaron's sons. And you shall make holy garments for Aaron, your brother, for glory and for beauty. And you shall speak to all the skillful persons whom I have endowed with the spirit of wisdom, that they make Aaron's garments to consecrate him, that he may minister as priest to me. And these are the garments which they shall make: a breastpiece, and an ephod, and a robe, and a tunic of checkered work, a turban, and a sash. And they shall make holy garments for Aaron your brother and his sons, that he may minister as priest to me. And they shall take the gold and the blue and the purple and the scarlet material and the fine linen. They shall also make the ephod of gold, of blue, of and purple and scarlet material and fine twisted linen, the work of the skillful workman. It shall have 2 shoulder pieces joined to its 2 ends, that it may be joined. And the skillfully woven band which is on it shall be like its workmanship, of the same material, of gold, of blue, and of purple and scarlet material, and fine twisted linen. And you shall take 2 onyx stones, and engrave on them the names of the sons of Israel, 6 of their names on the one stone, and the names of the remaining 6 on the other stone, according to their birth. As a jeweler engraves a signet, you shall engrave the 2 stones according to the names of the sons of Israel. You shall set them in filigree settings of gold, and you shall put the 2 stones on the shoulder pieces of the ephod as stones of material for the sons of Israel, and Aaron shall bear their names before the Lord on his 2 shoulders for a memorial. And you shall make filigree settings of gold, and 2 chains of pure gold. You shall make them of twisted cordage work, and you shall put the corded chains on the filigree settings. And you shall make a breastpiece of judgment, the work of a skillful workman, like the work of the ephod you shall make it, of gold, of blue, and purple, and scarlet material, and fine twisted linen you shall make it. It shall be square and folded double, a span in length and a span in width. And you shall mount it on 4 rows of stones. And you shall mount on it 4 rows of stones. The first row shall be a row of ruby, topaz, and emerald. And the second row, a turquoise, a sapphire, and a diamond. And the third row, a jacinth, an agate, and an amethyst. And the fourth row, a beryl, and an onyx, and a jasper. They shall be set in gold filigree. And the stones shall be according to the names of the sons of Israel, 12 according to their names. They shall be like the engravings of a seal, each according to his name, for the 12 tribes. And you shall make on the breastpiece chains of twisted cordage work in pure gold. And you shall make on the breastpiece 2 rings of gold, and shall put 2 rings on the 2 ends of the breastpiece. And you shall put the 2 cords of gold on the 2 rings at the ends of the breastpiece. And you shall put the other 2 ends of the 2 cords on the filigree settings, and put them on the shoulder pieces of the ephod at the front of it. And you shall make 2 rings of gold, and shall place them on the 2 ends of the breastpiece, on the edge of it, which is toward the inner side of the ephod. And you shall make 2 rings of gold, and put them on the bottom of the 2 shoulder pieces of the ephod, on the front of it, close to the place where it is joined, above the skillfully woven band of the ephod. And they shall bind the breastpiece by its rings to the rings of the ephod with a blue cord, that it may be on the skillfully woven band of the ephod, and that the breastpiece may not come loose from the ephod. And Aaron shall carry the names of the sons of Israel in the breastpiece of judgment over his heart when he enters the holy place, for a memorial before the Lord continually. And you shall put in the breastpiece of judgment the Urim and the Thummim, and they shall be over Aaron's heart when he goes in before the Lord. And Aaron shall carry the judgment of the sons of Israel over his heart before the Lord continually. And you shall make the robe of the ephod all of blue. And there shall be an opening at his top in the middle of it. Around its opening there shall be a binding of woven work, as it were the opening of a coat of mail, that it may not be torn. And you shall make on its hem pomegranates of blue and purple and scarlet material all around on its hem, and bells of gold between them all around. A golden bell and a pomegranate, a golden bell and a pomegranate all around on the hem of the robe. And it shall be on Aaron when he ministers, and its tinkling may be heard when he enters and leaves the holy place before the Lord, that he may not die. You shall also make a plate of pure gold, and shall engrave on it like the engravings of a seal, holy to the Lord. And you shall fasten it on a blue cord, and it shall be on the turban. It shall be at the front of the turban, and it shall be on Aaron's forehead. And Aaron shall take away the iniquity of the holy things which the sons of Israel consecrate, with regard to all their holy gifts. And it shall always be on his forehead, that they may be accepted before the Lord. And you shall weave the tunic of checkered work of fine linen, and you shall make a turban of fine linen, and you shall make a sash, the work of a weaver. And for Aaron's sons you shall make tunics. You shall also make sashes for them, and you shall make caps for them, for glory and for beauty. And you shall put them on Aaron your brother, and on his sons with him, and you shall anoint them, and ordain them, and consecrate them, that they may serve me as priests. And you shall make for them linen breeches to cover their bare flesh. They shall reach from the loins even to the thighs, and they shall be on Aaron and on his sons when they enter the tent of meeting, or when they approach the altar to minister in the holy place, so that they do not incur guilt and die. It shall be a statute forever to him and to his descendants after him. Exodus chapter 29. Now this is what you shall do to them, to consecrate them to minister as priests to me. Take 1 young bull and 2 rams without blemish, and unleavened bread and unleavened cakes mixed with oil, and unleavened wafers spread with oil. You shall make them of fine wheat flour, and you shall put them in 1 basket, and present them in the basket along with the bull and the rams. Then you shall bring Aaron and his sons to the doorway of the tent of meeting, and wash them with water. And you shall take the garments and put on Aaron the tunic and the robe of the ephod and the breastpiece, and gird him with the skillfully woven band of the ephod. And you shall set the turban on his head and put the holy crown on the turban. Then you shall take the anointing oil and pour it on his head and anoint him. And you shall bring his sons and put tunics on them. And you shall gird them with the sashes, Aaron and his sons, and bind caps on them. And they shall have the priesthood by a perpetual statute. So you shall ordain Aaron and his sons. Then you shall bring the bull before the tent of meeting, and Aaron and his sons shall lay their hands on the head of the bull, and you shall slaughter the bull before the Lord at the doorway of the tent of meeting. And you shall take some of the blood of the bull and put it on the horns of the altar with your finger, and you shall pour out all the blood at the base of the altar. And you shall take all the fat that covers the entrails and the lobe of the liver and the two kidneys and the fat that is on them and offer them up in smoke on the altar. But the flesh of the bull and its hide and its refuse you shall burn with fire outside the camp. It is a sin offering. You shall also take the one ram, and Aaron and his sons shall lay their hands on the head of the ram, and you shall slaughter the ram and shall take its blood and sprinkle it around the altar. Then you shall cut the ram into pieces and wash its entrails and its legs and put them with its pieces and its head. And you shall offer up in smoke the whole ram on the altar. It is a burnt offering to the Lord. It is a soothing aroma, an offering by fire to the Lord. Then you shall take the other ram, and Aaron and his sons shall lay their hands on the head of the ram. And you shall slaughter the ram and take some of its blood and put it on the lobe of Aaron's right ear and on the lobes of his sons' right ears and on the thumbs of their right hands and on the big toes of their right feet, and sprinkle the rest of the blood around on the altar. Then you shall take some of the blood that is on the altar and some of the anointing oil and sprinkle it on Aaron and on his garments and on his sons and on his sons' garments with him. So he and his garments shall be consecrated, as well as his sons and his sons' garments with him. You shall also take the fat from the ram and the fat tail and the fat that covers the entrails and the lobe of the liver and the two kidneys and the fat that is on them and the right thigh, for it is a ram of ordination. And one cake of bread and one cake of bread mixed with oil and one wafer from the basket of unleavened bread, which is set before the Lord. And you shall put all these in the hands of Aaron and in the hands of his sons, and shall wave them as a wave offering before the Lord. And you shall take them from their hands and offer them up in smoke on the altar, on the burnt offering, for it is for a soothing aroma before the Lord. It is an offering by fire to the Lord. Then you shall take the breast of Aaron's ram of ordination and wave it as a wave offering before the Lord, and it shall be your portion. And you shall consecrate the breast of the wave offering and the thigh of the heave offering, which was waved and which was offered from the ram of ordination, from the one which was for Aaron and from the one which was for his sons. And it shall be for Aaron and his sons as their portion forever from the sons of Israel, for it is a heave offering. And it shall be a heave offering from the sons of Israel, from the sacrifices of their peace offerings, even their heave offering to the Lord. And the holy garments of Aaron shall be for his sons after him, that in them they may be anointed and ordained. For 7 days the one of his sons who is priest in his stead shall put them on when he enters the tent of meeting to minister in the holy place. And you shall take the ram of ordination and boil its flesh in a holy place. And Aaron and his sons shall eat the flesh of the ram, and the bread that is in the basket at the doorway of the tent of meeting. Thus they shall eat those things by which atonement was made at their ordination and consecration, but a layman shall not eat them because they are holy. And if any of the flesh of ordination or any of the bread remains until morning, then you shall burn the remainder with fire. It shall not be eaten because it is holy. And thus you shall do to Aaron and to his sons according to all that I have commanded you. You shall ordain them through 7 days, and each day you shall offer a bull as a sin offering for atonement. And you shall purify the altar when you make atonement for it, and you shall anoint it to consecrate it. For 7 days you shall make atonement for the altar and consecrate it. Then the altar shall be most holy, and whatever touches the altar shall be holy. Now this is what you shall offer on the altar: 2 one-year-old lambs each day continuously. The one lamb you shall offer in the morning, and the other lamb you shall offer at twilight, that there shall be 1/10 of an ephah of fine flour mixed with 1/4 of a hin of beaten oil and 1/4 of a hin of wine for the libation with one lamb. And the other lamb you shall offer at twilight, and shall offer it the same with it the same grain offering as the morning, and the same libation for a soothing aroma as an offering by fire to the Lord. It shall be a continual burnt offering throughout your generations at the doorway of the tent of meeting before the Lord, where I will meet with you to speak with you there. And I will meet there with the sons of Israel, and it shall be consecrated by my glory. And I will consecrate the tent of meeting and the altar. I will also consecrate Aaron and his sons to minister as priests to me. And I will dwell among the sons of Israel and will be their God. And they shall know that I am the Lord their God, who brought them out of the land of Egypt, that I might dwell among them. I am the Lord their God. Exodus chapter 30. Moreover, you shall make an altar as a place of burning incense. You shall make it of acacia wood. Its length shall be a cubit, and its width a cubit. It shall be square, and its height shall be 2 cubits. Its horns shall be of 1 piece with it. And you shall overlay it with pure gold, its top and its sides all around, and its horns. And you shall make a gold molding all around for it. And you shall make 2 gold rings for it under its molding. You shall make them on its 2 side walls, on opposite sides, and they shall be holders for poles with which to carry it. And you shall make the poles of acacia wood and overlay them with gold. And you shall put this altar in front of the veil that is near the ark of the testimony, and in front of the mercy seat that is over the ark of testimony, where I will meet with you. And Aaron shall burn fragrant incense on it. He shall burn it every morning when he trims the lamps. And when Aaron trims the lamps at twilight, he shall burn incense. There shall be perpetual incense before the Lord throughout your generations. You shall not offer any strange incense on this altar, or burnt offering or meal offering, and you shall not pour out a libation on it. And Aaron shall make atonement on its horns once a year. He shall make atonement on it with the blood of the sin offering of atonement once a year throughout your generations. It is most holy to the Lord. The Lord also spoke to Moses, saying, when you take a census of the sons of Israel to number them, then each one of them shall give a ransom for himself to the Lord when you number them, that there may be no plague among them when you number them. This is what everyone who is numbered shall give: 1/2 shekel according to the shekel of the sanctuary. The shekel is 20 gerahs. 1/2 shekel as a contribution to the Lord. Everyone who is numbered from 20 years old and over shall give the contribution to the Lord. The rich shall not pay more, and the poor shall not pay less than 1/2 shekel, when you give the contribution to the Lord and make atonement for yourselves. And you shall take the atonement money from the sons of Israel and shall give it for the service of the tent of meeting, that there may be a memorial for the sons of Israel before the Lord to make atonement for yourselves. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, you shall also make a laver of bronze with its base of bronze for washing, and you shall put it between the tent of meeting and the altar, and you shall put water in it. And Aaron and his sons shall wash their hands and their feet from it. When they enter the tent of meeting, they shall wash with water that they may not die. Or when they approach the altar to minister by offering up in smoke as fire sacrifice to the Lord. So they shall wash their hands and their feet that they may not die. And it shall be a perpetual statute for them, for Aaron and his descendants throughout their generations. Moreover, the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, take also for yourself the finest of spices, of flowing myrrh 500 shekels, and of fragrant cinnamon 1/2 as much, 250, and of fragrant cane 250, and of cassia 500, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, and of olive oil 1 hin. And you shall make of these a holy anointing oil, a perfume mixture, a work of a perfumer. And it shall be a holy anointing oil, and with it you shall anoint the tent of meeting and the ark of the testimony, and the table and all its utensils, and the lampstand and its utensils, and the altar of incense, and the altar of burnt offering and all its utensils, and the laver and its stand. You shall also consecrate them, that they may be most holy. Whatever touches them shall be holy. And you shall anoint Aaron and his sons and consecrate them, and they may minister as priests to me. And you shall speak to the sons of Israel, saying, this shall be a holy anointing oil to me throughout your generations. It shall not be poured on anyone's body, nor shall you make any like it in the same proportions. It is holy, and it shall be holy to you. Whoever shall mix any like it, or whoever puts any of it on a layman, shall be cut off from his people. Then the Lord said to Moses, take for yourselves spices, stacte and anica and galbanum, spices with pure frankincense. There shall be an equal part of each. And with it you shall make incense, a perfume, the work of a perfumer, salted, pure, and holy. And you shall beat some of it very fine, and put part of it before the testimony in the tent of meeting, where I shall meet with you. And it shall be most holy to you. And the incense which you shall make, you shall not make in the same proportions for yourselves. It shall be holy to you for the Lord. Whomever shall make any like it to use as perfume shall be cut off from his people.